talk about the America truck some later today. Before we get started with the run, I want to say thank you to everyone that's been watching the channel, and I hit the wrong button first thing. Always good. I want to say thank you to everyone that's been watching the channel, everyone that's been subscribing to the channel. It means so much. Thank you, and I hope you enjoy the content. So we're on my second profile. They will be using the SCS Pennybook 389. We got some utility poles, and the shortest run I could find was 365 miles. Well, let's get on the road. The truck's running a Cummins N14 with an 18-speed Eaton Ford transmission. And guys, don't worry, more modded truck stuff is coming. I know you guys like that. I know you got y'all like the mod reviews and stuff. All that's coming. And always remember, if you do like the content, always subscribe to the channel.
Get ready to turn right.
And hit the like button. Now, normally I don't do that. That's not the type of person I am.
Turn right.
But I can tell you that YouTube is really pushing us smaller channels to do that. It's something they're pushing on all of us, you know, to get as much as we can, you know. I think we'll get some daylight so we can get a thumbnail.
Get ready to turn right.
That ambulance is behind us. I hit the wrong button.
Turn right.
Also, guys, let me know if you want to see more ETS, too. I can tell you that it did not get as many viewers as what I got with it, what I give with ETS. So, you know, if you don't want to see that, that's understandable. We won't have to do no more. I'll just play it in my free time. I don't play it near as much as I play this.
Get ready
to
turn left.
That's totally understandable. They gonna let us out. So I am still not running any of Jazzy Cat's traffic mods or anything. The game runs so much smoother without his mods, but just to be honest with you. I'm not running the Metropolitan Police Pack right now because I'm using the mod that gives the sirens and the lights for the default police cars. And it does not work with that Metropolitan Police Pack. It does still need work, though. I can say the mod is not where it should be. But, you know, hats off to the developer of it for bringing it. You know, any mod is appreciated. So also I've had questions about this engine that I'm using for this N4 and this Peterbilt. And I only use this engine in the 389 and the W900. I think those two trucks really fit this engine. Unfortunately, it's not offered in the International 9900. I would use it for that, but it's not offered for that, so I don't use it for it. But I don't see this engine being like in a 579 or something like that. It wouldn't fit in for that truck. Using a realistic weather mod right now too, makes the weather a little bit more realistic in the game. Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't tell you where we're going. We're going. We have utility poles where we're from, going from Curtis to Gillip, New Mexico. So we're in New Mexico right now. Got a little bit ahead of myself. It's been a while since I've been down here in New Mexico. It's good to do a little bit of running down here. I gotta get back up into Montana. So if you have not heard, SCS has released some more stuff about Texas, about all the construction sites that we're gonna see in the Texas DLC. Also, there's been a video release from a separate YouTuber about all the new companies and stuff that we're going to see for Texas that SCS is making.
Go straight on. That's right.
It's always great to see new companies come to the game. You get new companies, that means these modders, you know, they have more they can work with.
And then turn right.
For these real company mods like this one, you know, there's more stuff that they can do.
Turn right.
So it's always great to see that. Yeah, but right now the game is running really smooth. I'm not using any of the JazzyCat's traffic mods. And it's running very well.